was one question that was the last question to come on the website. And when I read the question, I said, this question cannot wait. This question needs to go before any other question. This question made me extremely happy. And if tamkeen is about nothing except that you ask such a question, this is by itself is an achievement, walhamdulillah. Here is the question that I decided, I said, this question cannot wait. No, I went way far. I feel as though I want to memorize the Quran and do all these things. You would imagine what these things are. But I am sinning too much and I feel it is stopping me from doing these good things. How do I stop sinning? Well, subhanAllah, whenever a question is being asked, I get notification on my phone, and I was reading the question and I said, alhamdulillah, if tamkeen puts this question in your mind, this is by itself enough. Someone who started to think, I want to memorize Quran and do all these things. May Allah help all of us to do these things that are in your mind. But I am sinning too much, and I could feel the heat in the question. I could feel the heat in his heart. I am sinning too much, and I feel it is stopping me from doing these good things. How do I stop sinning? Let me tell you something. Before we tell you how you may stop sinning, let me tell you by you asking this question. This is by itself a good sign. Shabab, keep in mind that whenever you go to Allah and you say Astaghfirullah, you said Astaghfirullah because Allah inspired you to say Astaghfirullah. So never think that you are gonna say Astaghfirullah because Allah made you say Astaghfirullah, then Allah is not gonna accept it from you. No. Allah gave you the inspiration to say Astaghfirullah. So Allah made you say Astaghfirullah because Allah want to accept it from you. Where I'm coming from this thought, if you read in the Quran, in Surah At-Tawbah, Allah says, ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا إن الله هو التواب الرحيم. They did not make repentance out of themselves. No. Allah repented on them so that they may repent. Which means He turned it to them, or Allah repented. Allah accepted the repentance first. Indeed. So they could repent. So for the one who asked this question, I am really happy with this question, and I would feel that Allah inspired you to ask this question because Allah is opening the doors for you. I have some suggestions for you. But before I give these suggestions, I want to ask anyone of the audience have suggestions for the one who asked the question. He believes that he is making sins, and those sins are stopping him from memorizing the Quran. And if you remember, ya Shabab, maybe a couple of weeks ago, there was a totally different question. The question was, I want to memorize Quran, but I am not able to memorize Quran. And we gave you the answer that the Sheikh of Imam Shafi'i gave to him. When Imam Shafi'i went to his Sheikh complaining, oh my Sheikh, I cannot memorize Quran. What do I do? So his Sheikh gave an advice to him. And Imam Shafi'i wrote this as, did you memorize those, Ya Rawan, or not yet? Not yet? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. So he said, شكوت إلى وكيع سوء حفظي. I complained to وكيع. وكيع is his sheikh. My bad memorization. فأرشدني إلى ترك المعاصي. He advised me to stop sinning. وأخبرني بأن العلم نور. And he told me that knowledge is light. ونور الله لا يؤتى لعاصي. And the light of Allah is never given to someone who is committing sins. So that was the question. But now we got a different question. The question is asking, how can I stop sinning? Let's get a couple of advices from the audience. Anyone want to give an advice? Please, microphone.
Sama.
Yeah, we can hear you. Keep going.
Sama.
Salah. Barakallahu fiq. Ah, hidayah.
So, you know, like,
no, I don't know.
I'm pretty sure she's listening to the music, so that's why she keeps singing it. How does she listen to Quran and then she'll be saying Quran instead?
Your advice is that he stops listening to music so he can read Quran more. Okay. Any other advices? Okay. Yeah, please. Let's take him and then Habib. Yeah.
When you wake up, like, just memorize Quran, like...
Shabab, there are a lot of noise from this table, please. Sorry, when you wake up?
When you wake up, like, just read Quran and before you sleep and...
Read Quran, especially when you wake up, correct? Barakallahu feek. Who else?
Habiba.
Habiba, and we have Sara after Habib.
I'd say get yourself busy, because if you're busy, you won't really, like, have, like... If you're busy and you have stuff to do, then you won't really... sooner think about it.
Barakallahu feek ya habiba, get yourself busy. So if you are busy doing good stuff, you will have no time to do the bad stuff or do the sins. Yes, yes, Sara.
Like, have things help you remind you about Quran. Like, a long time ago, we always had this excuse that we forgot to read Quran. But then my parents, they bought, like, these things to hang up, and they said Quran on them.
Barakallahu feek. Very good advices, mashallah. May Allah reward you the best. If you come up with another advice, let me know. But before I shabab, I get... Do you want an advice? We are going to come to some of the hadith. Again, there are many hadith, ya shabab. I just, you know, to make it short, but if you want me to talk for a couple of hours regarding this topic, I can bring you a bunch of hadith. But here are a couple of them. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والذي نفسي بيده by Allah, by the one in whose hand my soul is, لو لم تذنبوا, if you are not committing sins, if you are not committing sins, لذهب الله بكم ولجاء بقوم يذنبون فيستغفرون الله تعالى فيغفر لهم. The hadith says, and he sallallahu alayhi wasallam is swearing by Allah, if you were not committing any sins, Allah would take you away, and then Allah would bring totally different people who are gonna make sins. Then they are gonna make istighfar to Allah so that Allah would forgive them. Keep in mind, ya shabab, we are as human beings, as our brother said, كُلُّ ابْنُ آدَمَ خَطَّاءَ. Every human being is going to be doing mistakes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves what? That you go back to Allah and say what? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. So shabab, keep in mind that it is human nature that we make mistakes. There is no way that you can completely stop the sins. But keep in mind, every time you commit the sin, Allah loves to hear astaghfirullah from you. Iblis says, Iblis is talking to Allah, telling Allah, وَعِزَّتِكَ وَجَلَالِكَ لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ مَا دَامَتْ أَرْوَاحُهُمْ فِي أَجْسَادِهِمْ. Iblis is telling Allah, by your glory Allah, by your dignity, I am going to make them commit sins as long as their souls are in their bodies. This is what Iblis says. Iblis says what? By you Allah, by your glory Allah, I am going to make them commit sins as their souls are inside their bodies. And Allah said, وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي, with my dignity, with my glory, I am going to forgive them as long as they are seeking my forgiveness. So for the one who asked the question, ya shabab, before I give you the advice of stopping sins, you need to understand that Allah loves to hear the word astaghfirullah from you. Advices. We have our brother over here. He's coming for the first time. What's your name? Ahmed. You said, ya Ahmed, read the Quran, correct?
What?
You said, read Quran. Make sense? And Yasin all the way at the back, he said what? Pray. Allah says, اتل ما اوحي اليك من الكتاب واقم الصلاه. Recite, O Muhammad, what has been revealed to you of the book, and establish prayer. إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. Indeed, prayer prohibits immorality and wrongdoing. So what is the advice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us in the book if you want to stop sins? Read Quran, do the prayer, then Allah says prayer is gonna make you stop sinning. يرحمك الله. So شباب, prayer, if you wanna stop sins, what you do? Prayer. But please continue to read the ayah. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ. And the remembrance of Allah is greater. Is the remembrance of Allah greater than the prayer? Yes. Yes. The goal of the prayer is that you remember Allah. And the goal of the prayer is even after the prayer you remember Allah. And this is, ya shabab, what we have been trying to give you training to do. Whenever we tell you, okay, here is the picture, look to the picture. What is it gonna remind you of Allah? Do you remember this training that we used to do many, many times? So the main thing, ya shabab, dhikrullah, is to remember Allah every time. Ya shabab, dhikrullah is something that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day, he was telling the companions of the Prophet sallallahu, his companions, would I tell you that is even better than jihad for the sake of Allah? The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever they hear the word jihad for the sake of Allah, they know that this is the top. He was telling them, would I tell you something that is even better than this? It is the remembrance of Allah. It's to keep Allah in your mind, ya shabab, every time. Again, one time, inshallah, we are going to spend 1 hour regarding the remembrance of Allah. And Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ. And Allah knows what you are doing. So if you keep in mind, if you remember Allah all the time, and you know that Allah knows what you are doing, this is going to help you to stop making sins. There is another ayah I'm going to give as an advice. And again, it comes back to the prayer, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ. Establish the prayer all the time, day and night. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. حسنات are gonna wipe سيئات. حسنات are gonna make سيئات go away. And this is a reminder for those who remember. So from the first ayah and for the second ayah, for the one who wanna stop doing sins, number one, read Quran. Number two, prayer. And the more that you make khushu' in your prayer, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna help you stop sins. Here is something else. Allah is telling you, hasanat are gonna take sayyi'at and go away. So if you wanna stop sayyi'at, what you do? Do hasanat. So hasanat can wipe the sayyi'at. And every time you feel that I have done something bad, you ask yourself, how can I do something good so that it is gonna wipe this bad deed? I know someone who decided, every time I'm gonna be missing Fajr prayer, I'm gonna fast the day. Which means I woke up late, I did not pray Fajr. What do I do? I'm not gonna eat. I do not deserve to eat till Maghrib. For sure, missing Fajr a couple of days and fasting, especially if you don't get suhoor, but I am gonna fast. It is training for yourself, ya shabab. I missed Fajr, I'm gonna fast this day. So every time you do something bad, try to do something good so that you can compensate whatever you have done. And at the same time, you are training yourself. Other advices from Layan. Wake up, Layan. Wake up, Layan. Quick, Layan.
So I have an easy advice. Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullu an-nas yaghdu fabai'un nafsuhu famu'tiquha aw mubiquha. All the people, when they wake up and in the morning, they put a schedule for themselves, even to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to please themselves or their families. So just maintain your niyyah in the morning that you want to make use of this day to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be sure that He will help you inshallah.
جزاكم الله خير. كل الناس غاد فبائع نفسه فمعتقها وبائع نفسه. بارك الله. جزاكم الله خير. So شباب, again, the one who asked the question, may Allah reward him the best. This is one of the best question that we have ever received. Someone who feels that, yes, I want to stop doing sins. Okay. Yes, yeah, Amalia.
Explain the process of
Tawbah. Okay, so the question, what we are supposed to do if you want to make Tawbah. So making Tawbah, it has three steps or four steps. Three steps. You stop doing the bad thing that you used to do. This is step number one. Number two, you regret what you have done. And you decide, I'm not gonna do this again in the future. Which means, I did bad sin. Right now, I stopped doing the sin. In the past, I regret what I have done in the past. I decide not to do it again in the future. So those are the three ingredients of Tawbah. There is a fourth ingredient. If this sin is not only between you and Allah, but there is someone else involved. Like if you took her money, you need to return it back. Which means fix whatever you have done. So the fourth condition is fix what you have done. And for those who read the Quran, go through the Quran, and whenever you see the word Tawbah in Quran, usually it does not come on its own. It either comes Tabu wa amilu salihat, so they repent and they do good deeds. Tabu wa aslahu. They repent and they fix what they have done. So every time you read the Quran, either you repent to Allah and do good deeds, this means you are repenting from a sin between you and Allah. So you read Quran and stuff, why tab and then he do good deeds? Because that was between you and Allah. If it was a sin between you and the people, it comes tabu wa aslahu or taba wa aslah. So he repent and he would fix it. So those are every time there is tawbah. Those are the two conditions, which means you do tawbah. If it is between you and Allah, that's it. You stop, you regret, and you decide not to do it. If it is between you and Nabi, tawbah wa aslah, and you need to fix it. Make sense? There is one case in the Quran where there is someone else involved, but you cannot fix it. You cannot fix it. It's over. You took some money or you slapped someone on his face long time ago and you regret what you have done, but you cannot find that person to regret that. What you do? What are you going to do? إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. If it was it involved someone else, but you cannot seek his forgiveness or you cannot fix whatever you have done, you repent to Allah and you try to make as much good deeds as you can with the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive me, or with the intention, because I did something bad on him, I need to do a lot of good deeds to be prepared on the day of judgment. He is gonna come, complain to Allah, tell him, she did something bad to me, give me from her deeds. So you need to make a lot of balance, because they are going to be taken away from you on the day of judgment. So if it was between you and Allah, tawbah, repentance. Between you and someone, you need to fix it. Someone that you cannot seek his forgiveness, what you do? Make a lot of good deeds, be prepared. They are going to be taken from you away on the day of judgment. But if you do it sincerely for the sake of Allah, you will come on the day of judgment between you and the one that you harmed and you were not able to seek his forgiveness. And this situation is described in the hadith. So that man, He wanna get the hasanat from the other person who caused harm to him. But that man already repented to Allah but was not able to pay him back in dunya. What Allah is gonna do is gonna come to that man, show him a big palace in Jannah. The man is gonna ask Allah, for whom Allah this palace? Allah is gonna tell him back, for the one who has the price. The man is gonna ask Allah, and who has the price, Allah, for such palace? Allah responds back, you have the price. The man is gonna say, how Allah, how come I have the price of this palace? And Allah is gonna say, by forgiving your brother. The man for sure is gonna say what? I am gonna forgive him, Allah. And Allah is gonna command that man, take your brother and enter Jannah together. Make sense? So those are the cases of tawbah. And ya shabab, every time you read the word tawbah in Quran, see what comes with Quran. If it is tawbah, if it is tawbah and aman, he repented to Allah and he believed, this means this sin is between you and Allah. Repent and fix, it is a sin between you and people. If it is, and one situation in Surah, which is Surah? He's hiding somewhere, I don't see him. تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا. Which is Surah? بارك الله فيك, Surah Al-Furqan. Okay. May Allah accept from all of us, ya shabab. So now I'm going to move to another question. The question that came, should we pray at school? So now we are switching topic. Again, I wanted to get this question first, but here we have a different question. Should I pray at school? My goal from this question is not to answer the question and say yes, pray at school or do not pray at school. No. We want to learn something, ya shabab, together. We want to learn, if we have a question, how we are going to answer the question. If you have a question that you cannot answer, break the question into sub-questions, into smaller questions. Try to answer each question on its own. Then, combine the answers of the smaller question, you are gonna reach the bigger question, okay? So we're gonna have a couple of questions. I'm gonna invite some people to come over here to the table where we are gonna be answering my questions. So here I'm not gonna be saying the answer, I'm gonna be questioning few of you. This is how we are gonna answer this question. And I'm gonna do the job for the first question, and I wanna get you trained for the following questions. So the following question, you are gonna be doing this one, ya Layan, inshallah. And you prepare the list for your question for the other ones. Okay, so let me ask you a question before I invite people. If you say, yes, we definitely should pray at school, raise up your hand. Okay, if you say, no, let's pray at home so it doesn't look good we are praying in front of other people. Very good, okay. So Siraj, for sure you are one candidate. We need to have the different opinions. Come over here, ya Siraj. Muhammad Mahfouz, come over here. Safwan, you are going to be our third panelist. Did you say no as well? We should not? Yeah. Okay, come help Siraj over here. Okay, yeah, grab chairs, yeah. I want to make sure that you are relaxed. So now I'm going to be the moderator over here, and you are going to be answering those questions, okay? So the first question is for Muhammad Mahfouz. What would prevent you from praying at school? Can you imagine something that would prevent you from praying at school? You can always use the microphone.
Your grades.
What about the grades? What's going to happen to your grade if you pray at school?
Because some people want to spend time in their class to study and...
Okay, so the prayer time is going to be taken from the class, which can lower your grade. Safwan, any other points where you think the prayer can, or there is something that can prevent you from praying at school?
No, I don't see anything that can convince me.
What would prevent you from praying at school?
Yourself.
What do you mean yourself?
You have choices to make, and then you just choose not to do it.
Which means you can be lazy yourself on your own.
Yes.
Okay, but you will not be lazy at home, which means you are lazy at school, but you are not lazy at home. Is it what you're saying?
Sure.
So you are not lazy at home, or are you gonna drop the prayer at home as well?
No, I'm not lazy at home.
Okay, you are only lazy at school. Zaid, What would prevent you from praying at school? Actually, be sincere. Let me know if there are any issues so we can address them over here.
If you have to like retake something, if you have to like retake something, and you have to come into the class during the prayer time.
Okay, so all the problem of stopping you from praying at school
but
is regarding, you know, you don't have time and you want to make sure. Do you want to convince me, Zaid, that you have no time open at school at all? Do you want to convince me that you do not chat with your friends at school for a long time? Do you really convince me that you have no time? You don't have 5 minutes to make wudu and pray? Is it what you're trying to convince me, Shabab?
No.
So time is not a problem. Is there anyone who would say that I do not have time? Okay, so I was able to battle all of them and win over here in this argument. So time is not a problem. You absolutely have time. Are there any other reasons from the audience? Yes, yes, Sarah. You might feel embarrassed. Okay. Sally.
A location to pray, like if you don't have a room or something to pray in.
Location where you do not have a prayer room. Yusra, let's make sure you know that Layan. Over here. We're gonna make sure that you make some exercise, but make sure Yani, you keep the wires as quick as I am.
Sorry.
No, but you have to think that, like, are you praying for the people to notice you, or are you praying for
Allah?
I'm not
asking you for solutions yet, Ya Yusra. I'm asking, is there anything that would prevent you from praying?
Well,
I have a specific question.
Yeah.
Is there anything that would prevent you from praying?
Time,
and we agree that time is not an issue.
Well, I mean,
then we got, you may feel embarrassed for, praying in front of people, correct?
Yeah, well, maybe you don't have space to pray.
Or you don't have a space to pray, correct?
Yeah.
Very good. Ah, at the back here, you choose your favorite.
Sometimes,
Yalaya.
Sometimes, like, you do have a room, or like there aren't.
I can't hear you.
Sometimes all the rooms are being used, or you do have
okay,
a room in mind,
space.
But it's being used.
The same problem that Sally said, it is space. Okay, Sally again.
Minna was saying, if you don't know the Qibla.
I know this is challenging over here, but if you face the sun, this is the south direction. Make a U-turn and a little bit. This is going to be the direction for the Qibla. Did I solve your problem? Try to find the sun. Sometime, inshallah, the sun is going to come over.
Mama.
Look to the sun at Dhuhr time. Make a U-turn and a little bit to the right. Inshallah, one day you are going to figure it's going to come out, inshallah, one day. Okay.
Me. Me.
Here is the other question, because I'm gonna come to yes, yeah, Hidayah. Let's take Hidayah before I go.
How about if you don't know what time it is?
You don't know what time it is? I don't know. This is hard. Yeah, I know. This means you are lazy, Hidayah. Okay. Now, Shabab, I'm coming back to you. Do you feel shy? Shabab, no, one conversation, please. We have guest speakers. We invited our guest speakers from all over the world to address this issue. So we want to make sure that we make the best out of their time. Hey, let's get back to, go back over here. Siraj, do you feel shy telling people you are a Muslim, yes or no, and frankly speaking?
No.
No. What about you, Safwan?
No, that's why I'm getting big. It doesn't really matter because everyone knows I'm Muslim because of my name.
Okay, that's good. They already know.
No.
Here's another.
No.
Okay, so another question for you, Zaid. Do you feel embarrassed by praying in front of people or doing something that people usually do not do?
I don't do anything.
So for example, if it is the time for the prayer and you have a 5 minute break, this is the situation, ya Shabab. And again, I want to make sure that we are sincere in the discussion. So now we have a 2 hour class. Then you got a break in the middle for 5 minutes. Can you go in the hallway, put your brain rug and pray, yes or no? Can you do it?
What?
Can you go on the hallways and pray?
No.
Why not?
I know.
Yes, Siraj, what are you doing, Siraj?
Because
there is someone recording here that you know are going to give him the answer.
Is this, what is it? What?
Admins. Take care of the younger kids who are making noise. Ah, yes.
By the hallway, do you mean like between classes?
Yes. And you stand here in the hallway and you forget everyone behind you and Allahu Akbar.
No, I wouldn't do that.
You wouldn't do why?
Because people are probably going to mess up your salah, and plus...
No, they are going to be, for sure, they are going to not stand in front, you're going to try and find the wall, and then you're going to, Allah, can you do this, yes or no?
No.
What about you, sir?
So like, you're saying a wall, but like, what if you're standing and then there's lockers along the walls, and what if someone wants to check their locker?
Yeah, but you can find somewhere.
What if you can't?
Are you going to do it, yes or no?
No, because it won't be available to pray.
Hmm?
I wouldn't be able to pray there.
You will not. Why?
Because it's inaccessible.
Okay. What about you, Safwan?
I'll take a corner or something. Like, it doesn't have to be in the middle of the way.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I don't care about the people.
Barakallahu fi. So we have difference in opinion, which is God. I have a job if there is a difference in opinion. Yes, Ya Muhammad.
I don't think I would do it because I would have a lot of questions after I pray.
Yeah, they're going to bother you with questions. Yes, Yusra, where is Layan? Okay.
You shouldn't pray like in the middle of the hallway because then you would be in people's way. Like you have to, like, I feel like you can pray for Allah, but like not in the way of people. Like at least like in a corner or like somewhere where you won't disturb
anyone. But people are still gonna watch you and look at you, correct?
Yeah, but like but they won't pay attention as much if you're like not in the middle of them.
Barakallahu fik. Maryam.
Why can't you just ask a counselor for a room?
Good point. I'm going to come to this later. Ahmadu. Ahmad, then I'm going to come to you, inshallah. Yes, yeah, Ahmad. Layan. Sorry.
You can, like, just, you can pray and, like, in the corner, and then, like, maybe somebody's, like, wants to be, like, a Muslim because he's, like, and you encourage them.
You encourage them,
yeah.
By showing Barakallahu fi, Jazakallahu khair, Ahmad. Malak. I'm trying to get your opinion, so maybe I build an opinion by the end of the day.
I think for girls it's different, and you guys should, girls should really find like a room. If you ask the front desk, they'll give you a closet, they'll give you some place. It's only 5 minutes, you just have to pray and leave. But for girls, like they did a social experiment video on YouTube where they had a Muslim woman go and pray in the streets of New York, and she was getting
staged.
Okay, she was getting like harassed because you're doing positions that people aren't, that you don't do in public as a woman and as a man, usually. And you find a wall that covers you, or go to like under the stairs or the closet, but you shouldn't be in public just bending over.
Barakallahu feek. Hidayah. Stage. Yes, Hidayah.
It might be embarrassing sometimes. It might not be. If you're somewhere like you, no one can see you, it's not embarrassing. But if you're someone that you don't have a space, like to pray with no one bothering you, that'll be. Yeah, that'll be good.
I want to say something.
If you were embarrassed because of your friends, if they were really your friends, they wouldn't really do anything bad to you, except maybe like say something good of.
Now it works.
Yeah, go.
I feel like if you were praying in the middle of a hallway, you wouldn't even have khushu'a in your salah.
You will not have khushu'a if you are in the middle
of
the hallway.
Yeah, you won't be able to focus.
Barakallahu feek. Last one over here.
Well, if you actually focused on your prayer, you wouldn't like be distracted even if there were a lot of people. And if there's somewhere where you can like cover yourself, you should probably go there, and not just go in the hallway, just because.
Barakallahu feek, Shabab. Let me just kind of summarize for a little bit. Let me summarize a little, and we still have another question, inshallah. I'm going to come to you later, Yamal. Give me a second, inshallah. Do you, urgent? Ah. Why? طيب let me tell you a few things يا شباب. We as human beings, I know that we may feel embarrassed praying in public in front of other people doing something that people do not usually do. That was my personal experience and what happened to me when I decided I do not care anymore. One day, I was in the downtown of Seattle, probably the Pike Place Market. And it was Zohr time. And whenever it is the time for Salah and I did not pray yet, I start to get itchy. I want to pray. This is the time for the prayer. But I felt kind of embarrassed praying in front of people. There is nowhere where I can pray. And I felt, you know, I'm kind of embarrassed praying of in front of people. Then as I was walking in the street, ya shabab, I saw some people almost naked and they have paint on their body and they are struggling, I don't know, to show or whatever. You know, you saw those people in the downtown over there. And whatever came to my mind, those people are not shy of whatever they are doing. And I am shy of praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who owns the land and whoever is on the land. Since that time, ya shabab, if it is the time of the prayer, for sure first option to make khushu'ah is to find somewhere where I can pray without no one looking to me. Yes, so I can have khushu'ah in my prayer. But if there is no place, and it happens a lot, as I said, I'm in the downtown of Seattle, or I am at the airport and my flight is gonna depart in half an hour, I need to pray. Wherever I am, I find a corner and I start praying. This is what I do. And what I keep in mind, people are doing something wrong and they are not shy of whatever they are doing. Should I be shy of praying to Allah, who owns the land and whoever is on the land? Coming back to your point, ya Malak, you have a very valid point. I would encourage that for our sisters to cover themselves while praying, find a room and asking for a room. And as you are gonna see over here, there is one point specific regarding. Did we ask the school or ask the principal, whatever Maryam, and she's not listening to me right now, she said, ask the school, ask the principal, I need a room. It is gonna come in a little bit. Yes, Saraj, before we move on.
Okay, first of all, that video was fake and it was proven that. Second of all, so at my school they gave us a room, but it's like an office of this one, like vice secretary, principal, I don't know. And then she's in there most of the time and it's kind of awkward just going in there, asking her to leave. And then you just say for meditation purposes.
Okay, Baraka, we're going to come to the room in a little bit, yes, Saraj. But here there was one question and probably we highlighted this question. Do you really care most about Allah or about the people? If it is the time to pray, which one do you care about most? Yes, ya Maryamu. Maryam, then Amal. Or you forgot what you wanted to say, Amal.
Okay, so I would care most about Allah, but I want to debate against Saraj. So I have a question. I have an answer to the last question.
Mm-hmm.
So like,
which is, do you skip Jumu'ah if you have an exam?
So like, I think you should because, no, I don't skip Jumu'ah.
Are you gonna skip the exam?
Yeah, because,
Okay. Again, each one on his own, he needs to think of those questions. Yusuf.
I also have an answer for the last question.
What would you do? Would you skip Jumu'ah?
No, you should do Jumu'ah because Jumu'ah doesn't last forever, but the exam does.
I'm not sure if the exam does. And by the way, Shabab, again, over here you have different options, and you have Jumu'ah at 3:30, you have Jumu'ah at 1, Jumu'ah. And again, some people are trying to make it easier for you, but this is not always the case. Quick, Shabab, because we want to move to the other question. Yes, Yade.
For the last question, I think you don't skip Jumu'ah because if you pray, Allah can like make the exam easier for you.
But there is not going to be an exam at all. Yalla, Habiba.
I think you should pray Jumu'ah because, like,
what about the exam? You're going to fail.
The day is said because if you pray and you actually mean it, like you have the niyyah and stuff, Allah's gonna give you hasanat, and He's gonna help you. He's gonna help you like pass the exam, and also because.
Barakallah fika habiba. Sara bin Amal. I want to listen to all the opinions.
I would say you should go to Jumu'ah because you can tell your teacher that that if you can do the exam at another time, but you can't have like Jumu'ah at another time.
Barakallahu fiki, Amal.
Okay, the Jumu'ah you can pray it once a week.
I said Amal.
But the exam you
can. No, sometimes the exam, if you miss the exam, you fail the course.
Okay. I would pray Jumu'ah and not skip the exam because you can ask the teacher to schedule it for another time.
Barakallahu fiki, for sure. My question, if you are not able to reschedule, yes, Malak, then I'm going to collect the obedience.
Does this work? Does this work?
Yes.
Okay, so you know how Jewish people, observant Jewish people, they don't leave the house on Sabbath, on Saturdays? So the LSAT, like the law school entrance exam, they have their own special date just for people who observe Sabbath. And that's because they made it a priority. They said, we don't leave the house on Saturday, we don't do this. So if you prove your point and it comes, you should avoid scheduling your classes on Friday. But if you have to, you legally can get your exam either taken before or after. And I read, or somebody told me that if a man misses Salatul Jama'ah 3 times in his life intentionally, ma bitsallahu alayhi, like you can't pray Salatul Janazah on him, and that's terrifying.
Yeah.
So,
do you listen, Shabab? If you miss Salatul Jama'ah 3 times, right? And again, Ya Malak, part of your duty, inshallah, as our future lawyer, is to make it easier for everyone else. You put it as part of the laws that someone can, or you are not allowed to schedule an exam at the time of Jumu'ah. Wallahi, Shabab, every workplace I go, subhanallah, the group meeting is always at Jumu'ah, at the Jumu'ah time, on Friday during the Jumu'ah time. I'd ask if either reschedule or I'm not there. Who else? Yeah. Omar al-Nur, and then we come to Muhammad, then we move on. Omar al-Nur, and then Muhammad, then we move on.
You guys are loud enough, just talk.
Pass it over. No. Do you want to say something at all? Yeah. Omar the Nur, then Muhammad, and then we move to the following question, inshallah.
Isn't there a youth Jumu'ah in MAPS? Isn't there a youth Jumu'ah in MAPS?
Yes.
So why would you need to pray?
Again, it is at 3:30, and alhamdulillah, some people, they established Jumu'ah at different time, which is making things easier for you. But you never know, Ya Omar, where are you going to be in the future? I came, whenever I first came over here, it was a small city, one masjid, one Jumu'ah. You never know where you are going to be. Noor.
During the long classes, you can just ask to go to the bathroom, make wudu, and then pray in the hallway. Because there's no one in the hall anyway.
For sure, for the prayer, you can make an excuse, leave the room, make wudu and pray. But Jumu'ah, you cannot do this.
Yeah, for the normal prayer.
Jumu'ah, you cannot do this. Yes, Muhammad. Send the microphone back. Okay, yeah, go.
So, Noor. You can actually take the exams before, like that day, for the actual day.
If you are able to. If you are able to, for sure. Yeah, Muhammad, if you are able to reschedule the exam, this question doesn't make sense. if you are able to retake the exam, this question doesn't make sense. If there are different times for Jumu'ah, this question doesn't make sense. My question, if you really need to choose between the Jumu'ah and the exam, this is something that you need to think of and what you are going to be doing, inshallah. Okay? طيب. Jazakumullah khair, shabab. Let's move to the following question. Again, ya shabab, remember, salah is fard. This is what keeps you in your deen. Whenever it is the time for salah, leave everything behind. I am gonna. خلاص خلصنا. We're gonna bring another panelist. Let me, ya shabab, conclude with something that I said few times before, but maybe not everyone listened to this. I give the example of salah, shabab. Forget the salah. If you are taking a course,
how do I lower the thing?
If you are taking a course and you need to take 10 exams, ya shabab, to pass the course, how many exams you need to take?
10.
In the first exam, you got 0 out of 10. Second exam, you got 0 out of 10. Third exam, 0 out of 10. I know some people who do this, don't be scared. Fourth, fifth, all of the exams, ya shabab, you got 0 out of 10. But the last one, you got 10 out of 10. What would you expect your grade to be out of 100? No. Again, listen to me. Give me the phone. No phone over here.
I need the question.
10 exams. Each one of them, 9 of them, you got 0 out of 10. The last one, you got 10 out of 10. What would you expect your grade out of 100? 10 out of 100, correct? Can you get 100 out of 100, ya shabab?
No.
Yes.
But here is, there is one thing, ya shabab. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grades, there is a different grading, ya shabab, that Allah can do. There are some places, ya shabab, in Al-Quran where Allah said, لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا, so that Allah would reward them according to the best of their deeds. So that Allah would reward them according to the best of their deeds. Which means, if one time you got 10 out of 10, everything else is going to be graded this way. You are going to get 100 out of 100. Trace, ya shabab, and this is good homework over the weekend. Trace in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا, so that Allah would reward them according to the best of their deeds. Where this ayah came, ya shabab? لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا وَيَزِيدَهُم مِّن فَضْلِهِ وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَن يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Which is surah? No. No. Which surah? No. It came multiple times, but the one I said no. Ha. No. No. At-Tawbah didn't come this way, ya Malak. At-Tawbah, it's different. It doesn't have way. Zidahu min fadl, it didn't come in At-Tawbah. An-Nur, Barakallahu Fiki. So, this description for what? If you want to be graded, ya shabab, this way, and all your grades are going to be according to the best of your deeds, do what? رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. They are men who are never distracted from the remembrance of Allah and establishing the prayer. If you are never distracted, ya shabab, from doing the prayer by anything, what is going to happen? Allah is going to reward you according to the best of your deeds. And what else? وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, and increase you from his bounty. So, ya shabab, there is a difference between someone who would ignore the prayer because I'm having a basketball game or I'm having a class or I'm studying, and someone else, whenever it is the time for the prayer, he is gonna drop everything in his hand and go make the prayer. If you are not distracted from remembrance of Allah and establishing the prayer, even if your deeds are up and down, Allah is gonna grade you according to the best. Can you do this in 10 minutes, Ya Alain, or do you need the... You can do it in 10 minutes? Or do you want to do it next time? Do you want to take your time? Look, which means we're not going to finish before the 10 minutes either way. Okay. The next question, Ya Shabab, inshallah, that we're going to be addressing, and this time I'm not going to be doing this one. The question is, if I was at school and the teacher puts me partners with guy, girl, what should I do? Which means, if you are doing a project and your teacher assigned you to a partner from the other gender, what would you say? What would you say, yes? What would you say, no? Would we do something else, okay? We are going to answer this question, Sarah, inshallah, next time. And I asked Layan, before we answer the question, we want to make sure that we divide the question into smaller questions so we can understand what are the problems, what can we do. Make sense? You still have 1 week to add and refine more questions. Okay, before we conclude, Ya Shabab, do we have any announcements? Any announcements? اللهم إنا نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء همومنا وأحزاننا. اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اجعلنا من العلماء العاملين الهادين المهديين واهد بنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا مجتمعين على كلامك متحابين في جلالك وظلنا بذل عرشك يوم لا ظل إلا ظلك. واغفر اللهم للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير يا شباب. We are heading to the field inshallah, soccer, whatever, kickball. We are going to play inshallah the field for some time, then come back here inshallah for us. Barakallahu feekum.